Today we meet the world's top 10 most powerful supercomputers of 2021. The term supercomputer refers to a class of extremely powerful computers, but what is considered powerful changes as years pass and technology evolves, and the specific workloads towards which they are deployed change as needs of enterprises and governments develop. From MBs to GBs, what is the maximum power of your computer, or you heard of someone? We can bet it will be in gigabytes only. A computer of high performance power is called supercomputer. Performance of the supercomputers is measured in floating point operations per seconds, FLOPS, instead of million instructions per second, MIPS. There is fun fact, did you know if our brain was a computer, it could perform 38 trillion operations a second? That's 500 times more than the world's fastest supercomputer. The world's supercomputers are now not only faster, but also smarter, and support a greater variety of workloads. Are you constantly curious? Then why not subscribe to Infiniti Insight for more videos like this one? And ring the bell for more fascinating content. And make sure you stick around until the end of the video. Here is the list of the top 10 most powerful supercomputers. At number 10 we have Frontera. Deployed at the University of Texas at Austin's Texas Advanced Computing Center in 2020, Frontera currently achieves 23.5 petaflops using 448,448 of its Intel Platinum Xeon cores. Like other supercomputers in this list, it uses Mellanox HDR to transmit data at speeds of up to 200 gigabits per second. Frontera is designed for academic workloads like simulation, modeling, machine learning, and big data. It has been used in various research, such as binary black hole mergers, brain cancer treatment, and solving chemical problems through machine learning, modular modeling, and quantum mechanics. Number 9. HPC5. Created by oil and gas multinational company ENIS.P.A, the HPC5 has a peak performance of 51.7 petaflops. This output is made possible through 1820 Dell EMC PowerEdge C4140 nodes, each equipped with two Intel Gold 6252 24-core CPUs and four NVIDIA V100 GPUs. The nodes are connected via an InfiniBand Mellanox HDR network technology with a speed of 200 gigabits per second, using over 10 kilometers of fiber optic cable. HPC5 comes with a 15 petabyte storage system with aggregate read and write speeds of 200 gigabytes per second. AP said it uses the supercomputer for various technological, environmental, and research purposes, such as processing subsoil data and developing subsoil models. In fact, this is how the company found the Zohr gas field in the Mediterranean Sea. The company has also made the HPC5 available for coronavirus research. At number 8. Juwels Booster Module. Installed at the Forschungszentrum Jülich Research Center in Germany, the Autos-built supercomputer Juwels Booster Module is capable of achieving 85 petaflops. This is equivalent to the computing power of over 300,000 modern PCs. The Juwels Booster Module is powered by AMD EPYC processors and NVIDIA A100 GPUs, making it the most powerful supercomputer in Europe. Juwels is currently involved in several projects such as studying drug binding over biologically relevant timescales, high-resolution weather forecasting based on deep learning, and plasma simulations for next-generation particle accelerators. Number 7. Tianhe 2A. Also called Milky Way 2A, the Tianhe 2A is a 33.86 petaflops supercomputer developed by China's National University of Defense Technology, NUDT, and deployed at the National Supercomputer Center in Guangzhou. It has 16,000 computer nodes, each comprising two Intel Ivy Bridge Xeon processors and three Xeon Phi coprocessor chips. As per NUDT, Tianhe 2A has a number of applications, including computational fluid dynamics simulation, business opinion analysis, and government security. At number 6. Selene. Selene is a supercomputer built by NVIDIA that is equipped with competitor advanced micro devices, AMD, EPYC processors, A100 GPUs, and Mellanox HDR InfiniBand networking technology. Selene is capable of performing 63.60 petaflops. NVIDIA uses Selene in various research, development, and production-related projects. This includes large-scale language modeling, autonomous vehicles, graphics rendering, and tools for quantum chemistry and genomics. Number 5. Perlmutter. The lone new entry to the top 10 list, this system is based on the HPE Cray Shasta platform, and a heterogeneous system with both AMD EPYC-based nodes and 1536 NVIDIA A100 accelerated nodes. It achieved 64.6 petaflops per second. At number 4. Sunway Taihulight. Developed by China's National Research Center of Parallel Computer Engineering and Technology, the Sunway Taihulight is equipped with 40,960 nodes of SW26010 many-core 64-bit RISC processors. Each of its processors contain 256 processing cores and 4 auxiliary cores for system management, giving it a total of 10,649,600 CPU cores. This enables the supercomputer to reach a processing speed of 93 petaflops. Taihulight is currently running at the National Supercomputing Center in Wuxi. It is used for research and engineering work, specifically in fields such as advanced manufacturing, climate, data analytics, earth systems modeling, and life science research. Number 3. Sierra. Built for the Lawrence Livermore National Laboratory in California, Sierra is used primarily for predictive applications in stockpile stewardship, which is a U.S. program for testing and maintaining the reliability of its nuclear weapons. The Summit and Sierra architectures are quite similar, with each of its 4,474 nodes equipped with 2 Power9 CPUs and 4 NVIDIA Tesla V100 GPUs. This enables the Sierra computer to perform at a peak of 125 petaflops. At number 2 we have Summit. Summit, built by tech giant IBM at the Oak Ridge National Laboratory, ORNL, in Tennessee, is the fastest supercomputer in the United States, capable of performing 148.8 petaflops. It presently has 4,356 nodes, with each one housing 222 core Power9 central processing units, CPUs, and 6 NVIDIA Tesla V100 graphics processing units, GPUs. Weighing over 340 tons and occupying 5,600 square feet of floor space, Summit can perform 200 quadrillion flops, store 250 petabytes of data. According to ORNL computational scientist Wayne Joubert, Summit is so fast that in just 1 hour using it, researchers can solve a problem that would take 30 years on a desktop computer. According to Tom Rossamilia, senior vice president of IBM Cloud and Cognitive Software, Summit is built with AI workloads in mind and seeks to address challenges like climate change, understanding genetic factors that influence opioid addiction, and predicting extreme weather before they happen. Finally, at number 1 we have Fugaku. Fugaku, the king of supercomputer, remains at number 1. Fugaku is a supercomputer developed jointly by the Riken Center for Computational Science and IT giant Fujitsu. Its specifications include a 512-bit ARM architecture with 7,630,848 cores and 5,087,232 gigabytes of memory. Its benchmark scores show why Fugaku is on the top spot. On the top 500, it achieved a LINPACK score of 442.01 petaflops. On the high-performance conjugate gradient benchmark, it scored 16.00 petaflops. And on the high-performance LINPACK for acceleration introspection, it scored 2.004 exaflops. Fugaku's current projects are focused mainly on COVID-19-related fields, including exploring drug candidates, predicting the conformational dynamics of proteins on the SARS-CoV-2 virus, and carrying out fragment molecular orbital (FMO) calculations for COVID-19 proteins. According to Satoshi Matsuoka, director of Riken, Fugaku has also contributed to the establishment of COVID-19 safety guidelines for the government and private sector, and has helped lead a digital transformation in the area of infectious diseases. Matsuoka also highlighted the supercomputer's speed in a real-world use case. Referencing research on COVID-19's spike protein, Matsuoka said that on the K-computer, Fugaku's predecessor, FMO calculations to investigate it would have taken days, weeks, multiple weeks. It took Fugaku 3 hours. Naoki Shinjo, corporate executive officer at Fujitsu, revealed that Fugaku has started shared use with other researchers starting March 2021. In the future, We anticipate that Fugaku's use will continue to play an important role in contributing to the realization of the Japanese government's plan for Society 5.0, a smart society initiative, in areas like drug discovery, as well as ensuring a secure and safe society. We hope this video has given you some insight and maybe inspired you. If you liked the video, give it your thumbs up and subscribe to our channel if you have not already done so. Click on the bell to always receive notifications about new videos. Thanks for watching Infiniti Insight.